We showed this picture already, right? This is the picture of the tracking of Andrew Blake's daughter. And the first question is, what is this state? All right. And the state, or the object that was to be tracked, was a hand-initialized contour of the head. On the left here, you see a bunch of contours, okay? In fact, there's even one that's up here, all right? Those contours are the contours represented by each or many of the particles, the top particles, right? And so, for example, you can actually talk about the mean state as being the sort of average of the particles. But that doesn't really tell you what it is. What do you mean, you know, the state of a contour? Well, in fact, what they did is they drew a contour and they said, because that's not a parameter, that's a shape, and they said, let's represent the state of that contour by an affine deformation, okay? Remember affine? Affine is, it's a three-point to three-point mapping, takes how many parameters? It's six parameters, okay? Translation, rotation, scale, and shear, depending upon how you count those. I mean, it's six, and you can sort of divide them up any way. So the idea is that each particle represents a six-dimensional vector. So by the way, that means our particles are living in a six-dimensional space. And the bigger the number of dimensions, the more particles you need to sort of fill up that space. In fact, it doesn't grow so nicely, does it, right? I mean, if I go from two dimensions to three dimensions, right, if I had 100 particles before, if I wanted to have the same density, I would now need 1,000 particles, right? It grows exponentially in terms of the number of dimensions. So for affine, we're going to need six. And as I said, each of the particles represents that. Here, by the way, is one of the videos, and one of the questions you might ask is, well, where do you get the dynamics?
Where do you get the dynamics?
Well, there are a couple of things you can do. The easiest thing to do is to cheat, all right? So the reason we're using dynamics here is that the girl is jumping up and down in front of a cluttered background. So to keep track of where her head is kind of a difficult tracking problem. That's why we're doing all this work to begin with. That's why we're using particles. But when would tracking be easy? How about if she was jumping around in front of a green screen or a white background, okay? Or in fact, even easier, suppose you put her in a totally black turtleneck sweater and you put her in front of a black screen, kind of like that thing. By the way, Megan doesn't let me wear black shirts because I'll disappear. But the point of my disappearing is all you would see would be my floating head, which would be kind of creepy. But it would be very easy tracking. So you could have somebody jump around with their floating head, track it very easily, and measure the dynamics. So one way of getting dynamics is to sort of cheat and get it from an easier system. And I think for a bunch of the stuff they did in Constellation, that's what they did. They had an easier problem.